So in this video we are going to study about permutations and combinations again. So we will be solving certain number of questions on permutations and we will be studying circular permutation in this video. So let's solve some practice, let's practice some more questions on permutation. So how many 4-digit numbers can be formed by using the digits 1 to 9 if repetition of digits is not allowed? So if repetition is not allowed, so that means, again, I'll tell you this solution using two methods. Firstly, the formula and that existing method which we have used in the previous video. So suppose there are four places, four digit number we want. So for the this first digit, how many options do we have? So nine options we have for the for this place from 1 to 9, right? Now suppose if one place is filled with this, one digit is this place is occupied with one digit. Now how many digits are remaining? 8. So 8 digit, there are 8 possible outcomes, possibilities for this place, right? So 8. Then how many possibilities for this place? 7. Then 6. So that means number of possible ways is equal to number of possible ways is equal to 9 multiplied by 8 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 6, which is 3024, right? So this is 3024. Now let's do it with the help of that formula also. I have explained that formula. So formula for permutation is NPR. So NPR means N factorial upon N minus R factorial, right? So total number of digits is 9. 9 digits we have, right? So 9P. Now we have to permute how many digits? 4 digits only, right? So R value is 4. So that means 9 factorial upon 9 minus 5 factorial, right? So 9 factorial is 9 multiplied by 8 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 4 factorial, 5 factorial, right? And this is 4, so we have to write it 4 here. 9 minus 4 factorial, so upon 9 minus 4 is 5, so this is also 5 factorial. So 5 factorial to 5 factorial get cancelled, right? So 9 multiplied 8 multiplied 7 multiplied 6 is 3024. So this is our answer. So in both the ways we can solve this question using this formula also and using that existing method also. Let's move on to next question, next practice question. How many numbers lying between 100 and 1000 can be formed with digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 if repetition of digits is not allowed? So 3 digit numbers will be there in between 100 to 1000, right? 101, 102, right? Maybe 999, right? So if repetition of digits is not allowed means we cannot repeat these digits. So this will be 978, right? And these type of digits we have to form, right? So total possible outcomes by which we can frame out these digits is, total digits is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, and we have to select only 3 digits because 3 digit number we want. So total ways is equal to 6P3, right? So 6P3 means 6 factorial upon 6 minus 3 factorial, right? Which means 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 factorial upon 3 factorial. So 3 to 3 get cancelled. Now 6 multiplied 4 is 24, 24 multiplied 5 is 6 multiplied 4 is 24 and 24 multiplied 5 is how much? 120, right? Now we have, suppose if in this case also, if we are selecting 3 digits, suppose 3 digits we have selected 0, 1, 2. So this is not a 3 digit number, but here in first place we have 0 is occupied, right? 0 occupies this first place, suppose. So these cases we have to remove, we have to, you know, subtract from this total number of ways, because this is not a 3 digit number. If 0 occupies the first place, that is not a 3-digit number. You can also assume this question in this way also. Suppose there are 3 digits. Now, how many possible outcomes do this digit have, this place have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 possible outcomes. But if we fill this place with 0, then this is not going to be a 3-digit number, right? So what we have done, total ways 6 into 5 into 4, right? But we have to subtract that number of cases in which this 0 occurred at the first place or at the 100th place, we can say. Now suppose if we fix 0 as this at this place, right? So from total number of ways, we are subtracting the cases in which 0 occurs at this 100th place. So suppose if we fix 0 at this place, now how many places do we have? 2 places. And how many digits do we have? 5 digits, right? So out of these 5 digits, we have to fill these 2 places. So next possibility, next permutation will be 5p2. So 5p2 means 5 factorial upon 5 minus 2 factorial. So 5 minus 2 factorial is 3 factorial. 3 factorial to 3 factorial get cancelled. So 5 multiplied by 4 is 20, right? So total possible ways according to question will be total ways minus the cases in which 0 occurs at the 100th place. So 120 minus 20, which is 100, right? So which is 100. So 100 are the total number of cases. We can also solve this question using this technique also, I'll tell you. Now suppose we have 3 places. We already have 3 places. We have to make 3 digit number from it. Now the digits are 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So how many options do we have for this place? 6. 6 options we have? No. We don't have 6 options. We have only 5 options because we cannot fill this place with 0, right? 0 cannot be here. Otherwise, this will not be a 3 digit number. So how many options do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can fill this place with 5 options. Now for this place, how many options do we have? Now suppose out of these 5 digits, 1 digit occupies this place. Now how many digits remaining, total digits? Now we can fill this place with 0 also. So now how many digits will remaining out of these 6 digits? 1 digit occupies this place. 1 digit occupies this place. So how many digits are remaining now? 5. So again we can fill this place with 5, right? Suppose here we got 1. So except this 1, how many digits do we have now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can fill this place with 5. Now for this place, how many digits do we have? Now 2 digits we have used here. So remaining number of digits is 4. So total possible ways, 5 multiply 5, 25, 25 multiply 4 is 100. So from here also we can get the answer. From this method also we can get the answer. By subtracting these 0, the cases where 0 occupies this 100 place from the total number of cases, right? So I hope it is clear to you. Let's move on to next question. From a committee of 8 persons, in how many ways we can choose a chairman and a vice chairman, assuming one person cannot hold more than one position? That means from a committee of 8 persons, we have to choose 2 persons, right? So from a committee of 8 persons, we have to choose 8 persons. That means 8 PR will be the possible ways. So possible ways, 8 PR, or we can say 8 PR is 8 factorial upon 8 factorial upon 8 minus 8 PR means 8 R value is 2, because 2 possible ways, 2 possible places we need to fill, a vice chairman and a chairman, right? So 8 minus 2 factorial, right? Same formula we have used, 8 PR. So 8 factorial is 8 multiplier 7 multiplier 6 factorial, we can say. 6 factorial, why we are writing 6 factorial? Because it is 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So that is 6 factorial upon 8 minus 2 is again 6 factorial. 6 factorial to 6 factorial get cancelled. 8 multiplier 7 is 56. So 56 is our answer. Another way to do it is we have 2 places. And how many options do we have for the first chairman place? This is chairman, this is vice chairman. So for chairman, we have 8 persons. Now, one person becomes chairman. Now, how many options do we have for vice chairman? 7 options. because one person has already become a chairman. So this is 8 multiplied by 7 is again 56. So there are two possible ways to do this question using this formula also and using this method also. Let's move on to next question. In how many of the distinct permutations, in how many of the distinct permutations of the letter in Mississippi do the four I's not come together? So we don't want four I's. So let's check. Firstly, how many total ways are there? So total ways is equal to how many words are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11 factorial upon total number of S, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 factorial. Total number of I, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 factorial. Total number of P, 1, 2, 2 factorial. So when we will solve this, 11 factorial means 11 multiply by 10 multiply by 8 multiply by 9 multiply by 8 multiply by 7 multiply by 6 multiply by 4 factorial. 5 also. 5 upon 4 factorial multiply 4 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1 multiply 2 multiply 1. So when we'll cancel this 4 factorial to 4 factorial, 4 2 times 8, 3 2 times 6, 2 2 times 2 2 times. So when we'll solve this, the answer will be 3 4 6 5 0. So 3 4 6 5 0, right? Total ways. Now in let's suppose I, we separate out I from this word. So how many I's are there? 4 I. So let's suppose 4 I we have written together, right? Together. So how many letters, how many consonants do we have now? M, S, 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 P, P, right? So how many places these 4 I's together can occupy if they comes together? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? So 8 places they can occupy. So 8 factorial upon how many S do we have? 4 factorial. How many P do we have? 2 factorial. And so these are the possible ways, right? So if we solve this, these are the cases when all 4 I's come together. All 4 I's come together. Sometimes in question, the examiner can ask how many possible ways are there in which all 4 I's come together. So these are the total number of cases. So when we'll solve this 8 factorial upon 4 factorial multiplied 2 factorial, this will be 840, right? So this is 840. Now we want 4 I's not come together. So 4 I's, total number of cases required or total ways required. 4 I's not come together, that means total cases 3, 4, 6, 5, 0 minus the cases in which I's come together. So 840, in which I's are coming together. So 840. So the answer after this subtraction will be 33810. So 33810. So this is our required answer. So I hope permutation topic is clear to you. At least a basic idea you have got about this topic. So just solve these four questions again, pause the video or watch it again. Now let's talk about next topic, circular permutation, unit 2, applied maths of class 11th. So circular permutation, till now we have studied linear permutation. Linear permutation means there were some spaces in which we were filling these spaces with some options, right? Now suppose in this case also, if we make a circle of it, suppose there are 5 places. So if we make a circle of it, so if we want to make want them to be seated at 5 places in a circle, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So that means what? We don't know which one is the starting point and which one is the end point in a circle, right? Here we knew which one is the starting point and which one is the end point. But here we don't know which one is the starting point and which one is the end point. So if we start the arrangement from this position, so this will also be the same option. And if we start this arrangement from this option and go in this way, so that will also be the same arrangement, right? So that means we can say repetition of arrangements are there. So for the formula for seating arrangement in this circular permutation is n minus 1 factorial. So this we will be using this formula in solving certain number of questions. Just remember this, why we have subtracted this one position, because we don't know which one is the starting point and which one is the end point. So repetition of cases will be there. Suppose there are 5 persons A, B, C, D and E. So just try to arrange these A, B, C, D, E in as much possible ways as you can, right? So the number of possible ways will always be 5 minus 1, that is 4 factorial. Just you try it and just let me know if there are more cases than that. So till now, till then, let's solve certain number of questions. So here an example. In how many ways 6 people can be seated at a round table? So round table means this case, this type of round table. So how many ways 6 people can be seated? So we want 6 people to be seated at a round table. So 6 people, that means n value is equal to 6, right? So formula for it is number of ways is equal to n minus 1 factorial. So we can say 6 minus 1 factorial. 6 minus 1 is 5 factorial. And what is the value of 5 factorial? 5 multiply 4 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1. So that is 5 multiply 4 is 20. 20 multiply 3 is 60. 60 multiply 2 is 120. So total number of ways, 120 ways. So this is our option. Next, find the number of ways in which 5 people A, B, C, D, E can be seated at a round table such that A and B must always sit together. So A and B must always sit together. That means let's take A and B to be one unit, right? Now how many options do we have? C, D and E. So total number of options 1, 2, 3, 4, because A and B we can consider one unit because they are sitting together. So total number of options 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is, that means number of ways is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 people to be seated on a round, in a round table, at a round table. So 4 minus 1 factorial, right? But 4 minus 1 factorial we have used, but we don't know if A comes at first position or B comes at first position. So they can also interchange their position. So there are two cases from here also, AB and BA. So that means we have to multiply this by 2 also, right? In case AB is there, that means one case. In case BA is there, another case. So this is 3 factorial multiplied 2 factorial. Now 3 factorial is 3 into 2, 6. 6 into 2, 12. So 12 ways are there. 12 possible ways are there. I hope it is clear. See, consider it a one unit. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 minus 1, 3 factorial. Now AB and BA can interchange their places. So 2 ways from here also. So 2 multiplied by 2. That is 3 factorial and 2 factorial, 12 ways. Next is C and D must not sit together. So C and D must not sit together. So how many total ways in which we can arrange these 5 places at a round table? So 5 minus 1 factorial. So let's write total ways in which 5 people can be seated at a round table. So 5 minus 1 factorial, so which is 4 factorial. 4 multiplied 3, 12, 12 multiplied 2, 24. So 24 ways. These are total ways. Now number of ways in which C and D comes together. Number of ways in which C and D comes together or sits together. So that means the number of cases will be same as like A and B sits together. So that is 12 ways. Same. How? Suppose C and D to be one unit. Now how many persons are there? A, B, C, D and E. So that is 4. So 4 minus 1, 3 factorial multiplied 2 factorial. 3 factorial multiplied 2, which is 12 ways. Same as A and B comes together. Only the differences of alphabet, right? So number of total ways is 24. Number of ways in which C and D comes together is 12. So number of ways in which C and D do not comes together. Number of ways in which C and D do not sits together. So these cases will be 24 minus 12 total minus the cases in which C and D sits together. That is 24 minus 12 is how much? 12. So 12 is our answer. So 12 cases are there in which C and D do not sits together. So this is our answer for C and D do not sits together, and that is our answer for A and B to be sitting together. Right. Next, move on to let's do another example. In how many ways can three men and three ladies be seated at a round table such that no two men are seated together? So let's suppose there are six persons, right? So let's first arrange women at three places, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's suppose this place is occupied by women, this place is occupied by women, and this place is occupied by women, right? So alternate places, this is the only case where we cannot make two men sitting together, right? If women occupies the alternate places and then men occupies the alternate places, then that is the only case where this condition can be satisfied, right? So in how many possible ways these women can be seated together, or these women can be seated at these positions? So forget about these positions, 1, 2, 3, that is 3 minus 1 factorial, n minus 1 factorial in a circular table, that is, let's write down, possible ways in which women can sit at these positions. Possible ways in which women can sit at these positions is n minus 1 factorial, which is 3 minus 1 factorial. 3 minus 1 is 2 factorial, which is 2, right? So two ways, right? You can arrange them w1, w2, w3 or w2, w1, w3. So these are the only two cases. Next. Now suppose we have made these women to be to sit at these positions. Now how many places are remaining? Three places are remaining in which we can arrange men, right? M1, M2, M3. Suppose there are three men, M1, M2 and M3. So suppose for this place, how many options do we have? Three options, right? M1, either M1 or M2 or M3. For this place, how many options do we have after placing a person here, after placing a man here? Two options, and for this only one option is remaining, because one person will be occupied here, one person occupies this place, and later on the remaining one will sit here, right? So that is now number of ways in which man occupies remaining places is equal to 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. 3 for this, 2 for this and 1 for this, or either 3 for this, 2 for this or 1 for this, any possible outcome you can take. So 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. So together they have to be seated together, right? They have to be seated together. Together means these two possibilities, these two options should come together. These two outcomes should come together. So that means number of required ways together seating arrangement. This will be 2 multiplied by 6, which is 12 ways. So 12 ways are there in which these men and women can be seated together so that no two men are seated together. So this is our answer. I'll explain it again. Suppose firstly we have arranged women, right? So for women, for arrangement of women around a circular table, how many options do we have? 3. So circular means circular round table is there. So that means 3 minus 1, 2 ways, right? Now number of ways in which men can occupy the remaining places, 1, 2, 3. 3 remaining places are there. So 3 options we have for this place, 2 options for this one and 1 option for this one. Or 3 for this one, 2 for this one, or 1 for this one. Or 3 for this one, 2 for this one and 1 for this one. So arrangement will be same, no matters what, right? So we don't want which man occupies which place. We want only men to occupy, not to sit together. That is 3 multiply 2 multiply 1, 6. So total outcomes will be 6 multiply 2, which is 12 ways. So this is how we did this question. Let's take another problem. One of the easiest one. Find the number of ways in which 4 people, E, F, G, H, A, C can be seated at a round table such that E and F must always sit together. So E and F must always sit together. So let's consider E and F to be one unit, right? So how many alphabets do we have now? G, H, A, C. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is 5 minus 1 factorial, right? Number of ways in which they can be seated on a round table. So 5 minus 1 factorial, but these E and F can exchange their places. F can also come at first position, E can also come at first position. So 2 ways for this also, that is 4 factorial multiplied by 2. 4 factorial is 4 multiplied 3 multiplied 2, 4 3 12, 12 2 24, 24 multiplied 2 is 48 ways. So this sort of example we already did here also. This is similar to this example number 2, A and B type, right? So I hope you have got a brief idea of this circular permutation. So this is all about our syllabus. So thank you all.